The future of the Jewish nation, Romans 11:1-16. I say then, has God rejected his people? Not at all. For I am Israelite also, of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin. God did not reject his people whom he knew before. Or do you not know what the scripture says about Elijah, how he speaks to God against Israel, saying, Lord, they have slain thy prophets, and have cut down thy altars, and I alone have stayed, and seek my soul. But what does the divine answer tell you? I have reserved for myself 7,000 men, who have not bowed their knees to Baal. So then also in this time was a remnant according to the election of grace. But if it be by grace, it is no more by works. Otherwise, grace is no longer grace. But if it is by works, it is no longer grace. Otherwise the work is no longer work. For what? What Israel saw did not reach him. But the elect overtook him, and the others were hardened. As it is written, God gave them a spirit of deep sleep, eyes not to see, and ears to hear, to this day. And David says, Let their table become a snare, and a stumbling block, because of their recompense. Let their eyes be darkened, that they may not see, and their backs continually bow down. I say then, have they stumbled, that they might fall? Not by any means, but by his fall salvation came to the Gentiles, to incite them to emulation. And if his fall is the wealth of the world, and his diminution the wealth of the Gentiles, how much more his fullness? For with you I speak, Gentiles, that as long as I am an apostle of the Gentiles, I exalt my ministry. To see if I can somehow incite the emulation of my flesh and save some of them. For if his rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will be his admission, but the life from the dead? And if the first fruits are holy, so is the dough. If the root is holy, so are the branches. Letter to Romans, chapter 11, verse 1-16. Dear brothers, we are still studying the Jewish people, because we have to understand this fact, that they were an elected nation, and now they are no longer. But Paul is making it clear that it was necessary, Jewish people to lose this exclusivity being the people of God, so that the whole world could have people, who also have the right, to be called a kin of God. But Paul reports here that a minority of the Jewish people accepted Christ, therefore, they became the people of God. Together with all those of all the nations of the world who have accepted Jesus Christ and have become heirs to the promise. It means that those who accept Jesus as their salvation, regardless of race or color, or culture, whatever, accepting Christ as God's people, and is part of the body of Christ. But Paul explains that it was necessary for the Jews to lose this title, as an elected people, so that we would have the opportunity to be part of the kingdom of God. Here in verse 8, Paul explains what God did to the Jewish people. God gave them a spirit of deep sleep, eyes not to see, ears not to hear, to this day. In verse 10, it is written, they drown the eyes that they shall not see. In verse 12, Paul says that his fall is the wealth of the world, and his diminution is the wealth of the Gentiles. And Paul reports here that he was glorified by being the apostles of the Gentiles, therefore, our apostle. And concluding, Paul says, if the primes are holy, also the mass is holy, and if the root is holy, also the branches are saints. He means by this, that if the Jewish nation was holy, until it lost this privilege, the remnant who came from the Jewish nation became holy, and those who came later, who are the Gentiles who have come to us, are also all saints, that is, those who accepted Jesus Christ as their Savior. They were justified and sanctified, and glorified by God. Glory to God,